Hi, I'm Ash. Welcome back to my channel.
Here's how I make color bass.
First, we're going to set the BPM to 150. Next, put a string sample playing an arp. But it's not just any string sample. To show everyone that you were a true 90s kid and to play on everyone's nostalgia, use the sound font from the greatest RPG of all time. Auto-filter it in. Write in a bass line like this. Using a Reese sound is a great foundation for this type of genre. By editing the waveform of the Reese, you can create room for any sub-bass that you decide to add in later. Introduce a melody using a marimba. Layer in a glockenspiel to play that same melody. Then realize you can't have that melody playing the entire time, so rewrite it for the beginning so it just doesn't come out of nowhere. Add in an atmosphere that's in the key of the song to play in the background. And all together, it should sound like this. For the drums, use a 4 to the floor beat. Make sure to pick a nice, deep kick. Oh yes, we go one deeper here. Layer in a percussion loop. Don't forget the white noise and risers. Some more atmosphere for the mood. And call it mood. Snare build. Make sure you cut off the lows. Same thing with the kick. Altogether, it should sound like this. First, you need a big kick with a nice transient. Have the EQ look a little like this. Add the snare on the halftime with a clap a little bit off. On the snare, cut off all the lows so that it has all that room for the kick, especially if they are placed on top of one another. Also, a little bit of reverb to give it some tail. Lots of rides on the quarter note. If you did it right, it should sound something like this. Using a modified version of the same progression, make a percussive mid-range bass. This is the preset I use. It's essentially an FM bass with the LFO mapped to literally everything. But the important parameter is the chorus pitch to give it a percussive sound and the cutoff on a distorted comb filter. From here, you can come up with the overall flow. I decided on a triplet drop, and this is what the LFO settings look like for that. Adding the wombo combo and a mid-side EQ to make room for the sub while leaving a little bit of wideness. Use another EQ to cut out all of the harsh highs and the mids that will be taken up by the color bass. Layer this onto the sub using the same bass line. Use the same bass line to build chords for the main color bass. Try not to stack too many notes at the bottom, because those are gonna clash. Leave all the dissonant notes clustered on the top. If you get your chords right, the sound design and mixing parts will be much easier. To make the main color bass sound, I use Serum. In Serum, oscillator A is just a detuned saw wave, and I set its LFO to match the same flow that we made with the drums. Map that to volume. I also have a low pass filter with the LFO mapped to cutoff to tighten it up as well. And thanks to Paper Skies, the main thing that makes this sound is a combs filter at the very end of the effects chain. Map that to cutoff, and you can get some crazy sounds. As for processing, put the wombo combo on and turn the saturator up, adjusting the time and the amount on reduce ambience to tighten up the sound. The more important changes come from the mid-side low cut, which is the same idea, takes out the lows but leaves stereo room for the highs, and another EQ boosting those high-end sounds to get that hiss. Finally, just a reverb and smooth operator to clean up the sound.
Nope, this isn't right. I saw on a screenshot on Ace Aura's Instagram story, and if you zoom in to this image here, clearly you can see a resonator.
Now, I do have a resonator, and I'm still experimenting on how to make it work, but these settings tend to work out really well. For this, I have it set to a minor 7th chord with the octave on top, and these are the semitones to get a minor 7th. Also, having the decay turned down helps a lot.
Whoa. I said resonator, not music theory.
Oh my god, just copy my settings. Jeez.
Next, I set up a trigger channel with a hi-hat on it, specifically for envelope follower. And then I use envelope follower by clicking that button and mapping it to the gain of the resonator. This way, the resonator's gain is automated every time the hi-hat hits.
Couldn't you just do this with normal automation?
But you can map the envelope to multiple parameters, and that really helps tighten up the sound.
Nerd.
Whatever.
Next, copy the chord onto a new channel. This sound is made with a detune square on Serum. Setting detune to 3 and mapping LFO 1, that looks like this, to volume once again. Adding hyperdimension and distortion to thicken it up. Distortion set to sine fold and drive around here. Make sure we're turning on mono, and we add the arpeggiator MIDI effect and set it to 132 with a gate of 69. Nice. Set repeats to 4, and you can also add note length and use these settings if you want to change the length of the notes of the arp. But this is optional. Once again, cutting out the lows and adding a reverb to give it some space.
So altogether, these 4 layers, sub, mid-range bass, color bass, and arp, mix those all together and you have a guaranteed Rushdown record release.
Don't promise them that.
Add a support layer like this. And copy the bass line onto a mid-range quarter note bass for more background details. Automate a frequency shifter if you want some cool fills.
Don't forget the obligatory rhythm tom fill.
Finally, we need some effects. White noise down. And this siren thing made with Serum. This is just a saw wave put to 16 with a reverb filter on it. LFO1 mapped to noise, as well as the cutoff on the reverb, and also mapped to the fine pitch to give it that movement. Layer it with the rest of the drums. This hi-hat layer is a triplet to be layered with the drop. These triplet hi-hats work as extra transients to make the drop punchy. And obviously you can't have your stuff looking like this. No, this is color bass. Make sure all your clips are different colors.
This needs something ridiculous.
I swear, Ash, if you do another distorted lead during the second part of the drop.
String sample.
Halftime the string sample. Copy. OTT. Lots of saturator. Delay.
Play. Let's go!
You're scaring me.
Altogether, it sounds like... you hitting that like and subscribe button.
Haha, got him.
If you don't want to miss the next video, make sure you like, subscribe, and comment on this video. I'd love to see what you're making using this. Now go make some bangers. Peace!